For those that are new, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and turn on all notifications to be notified whenever a brand new video is posted onto this channel. Thank you all so much for your continued support. Now let's begin. With David Gordon Green's Halloween movie set to be released on October 19th, 2018, we have some brand new information courtesy of BloodyDisgusting.com, which reveals some very intriguing information that I do think all Halloween fans ought to hear, especially coming from the mouth of Danny McBride. Now, according to this recent article, the upcoming 2018 Halloween film will in fact pay homage to the original Halloween movies. Now, to me, this is a tad bit concerning, and as the following quote goes on to state, Danny McBride adds by saying, "This picks up after the first one. The Halloween franchise has kind of become a little bit of a choose-your-own-adventure. You know, like there's so many different versions and timelines, so it's all mixed up. We just thought it would be easier to go back to the source and continue from there." As McBride added in saying, "We do reference the other films. For fans, we pay homage and respect to every Halloween that has ever been out there." So, to me, this is a tad bit concerning because if this particular Halloween film is supposed to take place after the events of the first, then how in the world is this specific movie going to pay homage to any of the other Halloween films that technically are supposed to take place after the first, when in this timeline, all the events that happened pretty much got retconned? So it doesn't make any sense to see how McBride and Gordon Green are going to be adding any sort of Easter eggs as to referencing the other films, because again, if this film is supposed to take place 40 years after the first, then why in the world are they going to pay homage to any of the other movies that came after the original when this is supposed to take place in its own different timeline that correlates to the beginning as its true successor, as its true sequel? To me, this is a tad bit concerning because we are going to be getting a trailer in the next couple of weeks, which I'm very excited for because as a Halloween fan, I do want to see in terms of direction where they're going to take this film. But this film also promises to be, and I quote, "the scariest Halloween film within the overall entry." So that piques my interest because I do want to see what kind of elements they're going to throw in for Michael Myers, what kind of elements they're going to throw in for Jamie Lee Curtis's character. But what I am really concerned for is the overall direction, as they are going to pay homage to the other Halloween films, but in a very weird way. It doesn't make any sense for them to even go back and referencing the hospital or any of the, you know, the Myers' family members, such as his niece, if all of that was supposed to be scrapped in this film. Unless, of course, they throw in a monkey wrench and they allude to the idea that perhaps maybe these events have occurred following said timeline, but the entire history of this film looks like it's going to be screwed up, especially now if they're planning on paying respects to the other previous films, which of course as a whole isn't a bad thing to do if this movie followed the current timeline of the Halloween franchise. But if they're going to be doing this and basing this film after the original, then how in the world are they supposed to pay respect to the other films if on a technical level the other films never happened to begin with? And don't get me wrong, am I excited as a fan to see the following events occur and them paying some sort of respect to the other films? Of course. But what I'm really concerned about is the overall direction in which they're trying to take Michael Myers' character, Jamie Lee Curtis' character, and setting up for a potential sequel if this movie does good, which by the end of the day, I do believe in my overall opinion, and I am prognosticating ahead of time, that this film is going to do amazing in the box office, and I do believe that Hollywood may potentially be setting up for sequels due to the idea that Halloween is a very popular franchise. But what I'm really concerned about is seeing where they plan on taking Michael's' character. So in the end, guys, let me know what you all think down in the comment section below. Do you guys agree or disagree with the overall concept of them having to pay respects and throwing in Easter eggs of the previous films in this upcoming movie? What are your overall thoughts on Michael's direction? What are your overall thoughts on Jamie Lee Curtis's direction? And by the end of it, would you think that it's right for them to include bits and pieces of the history of Halloween within its movies in this particular film by adding in references and Easter eggs to the hospital, to Michael Myers' extended family with his niece, and possibly even referencing Halloween 3, Halloween 5, and even possibly the asylum, referencing every little tidbit that we've seen in the previous Halloween films? Do you believe that it's possible for them to do that? And by the end of it, what are your overall thoughts on this film being labeled as the scariest Halloween film within the entire franchise thus far? I'm gonna have to wait and see as to if they're really gonna be correct on that assumption and letting us see the movie for ourselves to judge whether or not this would be the scariest installment within the franchise. Even though I don't believe it could be, the first movie and potentially even the second were the best in the entire entry. However, I do have hopes for this film, as I do believe that John Carpenter and said directors could do a good job, but based on the information that we've been getting, it doesn't look to be the case. So let me know what you all think down below, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys are new to this channel, hit that subscribe button, guys. Turn on all notifications. If you guys want to go on ahead and watch more Halloween videos, you guys can click the description box and check out the official Halloween playlist, so you guys can go on ahead and watch all your favorite Halloween videos down below. Thank you all so much for watching. Tune back in for more, and I'll be seeing you all down in the comment section below. Take it easy, guys. Peace.